And so now let's give the explanation for the quiz.
All right. So let's see what happened here. So what you're saying is in some cases the inputs are discrete or continuous or complicated. In other cases, the outputs can be discrete or continuous or complicated. But I think what you're saying is that what matters to determine if something's classification or regression is whether the output is from a discrete small set or whether it's some continuous quantity. Is that right?
Right, that's exactly right. What the difference between a classification task or a regression task is not about the input, it's about the output. If the output is continuous, then it's regression, and if the output is small discrete set or discrete set, then it is a classification task. So with that in mind, what do you think is the answer to the first one? Michael.
So lend money. If it was something like predicting a credit score, that seems like a more continuous quantity. But this is just a yes-no, so that's a discrete class, so I'm going to go with classification.
That is correct. It is classification, and the short answer is because it's a binary task. True, false, yes-no, lend money or don't lend money.
Got it.
So it's a simple classification task. Okay, with that in mind, what about number two?
All right, so number two, it's trying to judge something about where they fall on a scale, high school, college, or grad student. But all that the system is being asked to do is put them in one of those three categories, and these categories are like classes, so it's classification.
That is also exactly right, classification. We moved from binary to trinary in this case, but the important thing is that it's discrete. So it doesn't matter if it's high school, college, grad, professor, elementary school, any number of other ways we might decide where your status of matriculation is. It is a small discrete set. So with that in mind, what about number three?
All right, so the input is the same in this case, and the output is kind of the same, except there's certainly more categories because there's more possible ages than just those three. But when you gave the example, you did explicitly say that ages can be fractional, like, 22.3. So that definitely makes me think that it's continuous, so it should be regression.
Right. I think that is exactly the right thing. You have a continuous output. Now, I do want to point something out, that while the right answer is regression, a lot of people might have decided that the answer was classification. So what's an argument? If I told you, in fact, the answer was classification, what would be your argument for why that would be?
Well, I guess...
Can you think of one?
I guess, if you think about ages as being discrete, you just say, you can be one or two or three or, whatever, up to 130, say, but there's just that set. There isn't really, usually we don't talk about fractional ages. So it seems like you could think of it as a set of classes.
Right. So let's imagine, how old do people, let's imagine we only cared about years. So you're either one or two or three or four or five, or maybe you can be one and a half and two and a half and three and a half, but whatever. It's not all possible real number values. And we know that people don't live beyond, say, 250. Well, in that case, you've got a very large discrete set, but it's still discrete. Doesn't matter whether there's two things in your set, three things in your set, or in this case, 250 things in your set, it's still discrete. So whether it's regression or classification depends upon exactly how you define your output, and these things become important. I'm going to argue that in practice, if you were going to set up this problem, the easiest way to do it would be to think about it as a real number, and you would predict something like 23.7. And so it's going to end up being a regression task. And we can maybe think about that a little bit more as we move along. So either answer would be acceptable depending upon what your explanation of exactly what the output was. You buy that?
That makes sense.
Excellent. Okay. All right, let's move beyond the quiz and start thinking about exactly what it means to define a classification problem, and then later what it means to define a regression problem.